So hey guys, this is Aurel Noor and today in this video I'm gonna show you how you can root your Realme 6 with the help of custom recovery. To root this device, firstly you have to follow some procedural step and download pre-requirement files. You will find all required files in video description. So without further ado, let's start the video. So guys, this is Realme 6. To root the device, firstly enable USB debugging and OEM unlocking from developer options. So go to settings. Now click on about device. You can see this is Android 10 based device. Now click on baseband and kernel version and tap 2-3 time on build number to enable developer options. Now navigate to developer options, click on additional settings and here you will find developer option. Now enable OEM unlocking and USB debugging from here. Now download and install in-depth application from video description and now click on start applying button and tick on their privacy policy button and click submit button. So our application is submitted. Now wait some time, it gonna take some time to be approved. So after 2-3 minutes, let's check my application is approved or not. Yes, it is saying review successful. Now click on start in-depth button. It will boot our phone in fast boot mode. Yeah, it is successfully booted in fast boot mode. Now put your phone down and connect it with USB cable. So our device is connected. Now let's move on to the PC screen. In PC you will require some files which you will find in video description. So go to C drive, program 86 folder and minimal and fastboot folder. Click on CMD here button. It will enable command prompt there. Now type fastboot devices to check your device is connected or not. Yes, it is showing serial number of my device. That's mean my device is connected. Now we can root this. Sorry, we can unlock bootloader of this device by typing fastboot flashing unlock command. You will also find all required command in video description. Now you can see in my phone. It is saying me press volume up to unlock your bootloader. So press volume up button. And then press volume down button to reboot your device. To reboot this device, type fastboot reboot command in command prompt. That is booting my phone in main system. So wait, it gonna take some time because our phone is wiped or it format our data, so it takes some time on first boot up. So as you can see, my bootloader is unlocked. Now it is time to install custom recovery on it. So again, let's move on to the PC screen. You need to also enable USB debugging in from developer option. Now I will give these command in video description. You can simply copy and paste these command in command prompt. Type adb reboot bootloader to boot your phone in fast boot mode. Sorry, it throws some error, so I'm typing again. As you can see, my phone is successfully booted in fast boot mode. Now I can install TWRP recovery on it. So copy this command from video description as I am copying and paste it in command prompt. Now let me adjust my screen to show you all required file for root this device. You can simply download this file and move on same folder. Now after pasting command, just drag and drop your vbmeta file, because vbmeta is necessary to install TWRP recovery on it, and press enter button. Now you can see my vbmeta is successfully installed. Now it is time to install TWRP recovery. So again copy this command fastboot flash recovery and paste it in your command prompt, type spacebar, and again drag and drop your recovery file from your required file folder and type enter button. And now type fastboot reboot button to boot your phone in main system. You can also type fastboot boot and address of boot image to boot your phone directly in custom recovery. So now as you can see, my custom recovery is successfully installed, and it is not TWRP recovery, it is PBRP recovery, which is similar as TWRP recovery. Now let's root it. To root this device, click on advanced button from PBRP recovery, and now type ADB sideload button and swipe to open ADB sideload. Now again type ADB sideload in your command prompt, press spacebar, and again drag and drop your magisk zip from required file folder. Now again press enter button to start installation. Now as you can see, my installation of magisk is started successfully. It will install root on our device, but some people face boot loop issue on magisk installation. So you can backup your boot image. In case you will face boot loop issue, you can simply reinstall your stock boot image to fix your device. You can also download these boot images from our website, which I will also give in video description. Now click on magisk icon. It will download magisk manager automatically from internet. Install it. So finally our device is rooted successfully. So enjoy root. Thanks for watching this video.